Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Joy Kaguri, Group HR Manager, the Standard Group PLC, and I'll be taking through embracing big data in supporting human resource with special emphasis on the specific needs of women in media, which is very much in line with the theme of AWI in 2020 in regard to reimagining the future, women in media, peace, and technologies. So, and you talk about data these days. What are we looking at? We're looking at the fourth industrial revolution, which is here with us, and it talks on AI, artificial intelligence, which is on intelligence of machines, big data. This is about being able to determine and get information that is very helpful in decision making, machine learning, use of algorithms so as to get data and make decisions, and also robotic process automation, as you've seen it in film industry, hotel industry, and also in health industry. So I'm going to rely a lot on a report which came from KPMG. We talked about the HREs of utilizing technology so as to meet the needs of an employee and the four capabilities in this area, which is going to chart forward the future of the companies for the future. And this is in terms in regard to shaping the workforce of the future, in this in terms of building capabilities and the skills that are required to manage the company in the future, in terms of a purpose-driven culture. What kind of a culture do you want to have so that can be able to deliver your objectives? Also in terms of redesigning employee experience by providing a very good employee value proposition, and also of course use of evidence-based insight. So for journalists, that is very crucial because you have to do fact-finding supported with data, which can be in the form of charts, in terms of tables, in terms of maps, so that you can be able to communicate effectively. What are the benefits of big data for human resource? What do we look at when you look at this? And one of the biggest areas is reducing cost. We find some, and I'm going to rely a lot on a report which came from Forbes, Human Resource Council, which gave 9 benefits. And one of them is a reducing cost. And in this area of reducing cost, it helps in being able to have a multi-skilled journalist as opposed to having a journalist with a single skill. For example, so you do not have any overlap of duties or repetition of duties, or in terms of having people doing the same job, so there's a duplication. We can have a photojournalist who can go out to the field, be able to get the data, take the photo and write a story and be able to upload it, and both on a digital website and also sent for to the TV viewing and also sent for the print. So it's very, very important to have analysis in terms of the skills that you have in the company and then be able to inform decisions of the kind of employees you need to help reduce cost and look, have a better value proposition and be able to effectively deliver in your business objectives. Another benefit of data is it helps you give an insight of the hidden talents that you have. Sometimes you find that a lot of decisions which are made are on the basis of how you relate with your manager or supervisor, or sometimes you can find managers who want to hire from out. So instead of doing that, what do you do? Build a very strong skill profile for your organization. By so doing, you can be able to profile the staff in terms of the gender, in terms of the department, seniority, academics, experience, and then you can be able to present this data to the manager when making decisions on how to either promote or how to grow the employee in terms of the career, in terms of when to train them. And this is very important, really, for ladies who are usually very modest and not able to articulate their skill set. It just becomes really handy in terms of being able to give equal opportunities to both the male and the female gender. Another use of the big data is improving strategic workforce planning. This is very important when you're acquiring talent, and sometimes you find that also how you manage these talents. With the COVID, you have learned that you can have alternative work arrangements. You can have short-term contracts, fixed contracts. You can have freelance and part-time employees. So there'll be a lot of hot desking and also paying employees on per piecemeal instead of having a full-time employee and maybe doing something which can be done over a short period of time. And also for us journalists, we do have a lot of correspondents who are able to give us information or stories which are published, and they're paid on per published story. Also, the work planning is also very crucial when you're able to you'll see the need as you move to, as the changes of the COVID has had a lot of impact on the technology, and this requires of having new data, and this new data can be areas of research, data scientists, areas of online engagers, social media experts, and we find that you'll have to train them so they can be able to first have the editorial aspect and then be able to address or meet the expectations of our customers out there. And then also the introduction of new machines so that you can be able to meet the expectations of the customers and also being able to match the ever-demanding needs of our audiences and readers. And one very important aspect of big data is you're able to unlock powerful insights. And as I've said, information is very powerful because it gives information from within and without. Internally, you can look at the employee engagement in terms of being able to look at what are the feelings of the employees in terms of being able to articulate or resonate with your business strategy, because the ones who try this strategy, they need to understand and be able to be provided with the tools and the skills to be able to deliver. And of course, in terms of customer service, how do you meet your customers in terms of satisfying their needs? And this you can do by being able to have the data, which can be mined by your researchers, the data scientists, the social media experts, the online engagers, and you can be able to make very informed decisions as an employer. Also, this data is helpful in identifying areas of opportunity. It shapes the company culture in terms of what kind of a company do you want to, what kind of a culture, or what are you going to be associated with. Are you going to be associated with a company that provides solid and the truth? Do you want to be a company that has been resonated with being able to have to provide very solid fact stories which have been fact backed by facts, and also verification is also very solid, and that becomes a very crucial aspect of data in the organization. Also, big data is also very important in enabling to retain our staff. We find that most time as organizations, the data we get, we only use it for the business, but we leave out of the people. And people is very important because you might have the best structures, you might have the best processes, but if you don't have the best products, but you don't have the people, you don't take into account the people as you make your business objectives or your vision and your mission, it's bound to fail. As you say, you can have the best strategy, but it do not work if it does not have people to drive it because they're not aligned. As it said sometimes that structure, the strategy, it's a culture for breakfast, something like that. Like you can culture, it's a strategy for breakfast. You can have the best strategy, but if you don't have the right culture, which is usually driven by people, you'll not be able to get far. Another thing which is very important with the big data is you're able to make decisions without bias. As I've said before, you can get information on productivity of organization, the region structure in terms of the gaps that you have, what needs to be filled, in terms of innovation, where are the gaps in terms of what the customers needs, and we need to fill it up by being able to come up with new products which meet the demands of our customers. Also the demographics in the organization, which can be on gender, age, and also the environment you operate in, within or without, the health and safety, which is very crucial during this time of COVID. Are you able to provide a very enabling environment for our employees? Also in terms of the total rewards that you give to the employees, that which is of course also backed by the reduced cost. When you have the right size of the employees, you can be able to afford them even better. And also in terms of mobility, being able to freely carry out the duties out there, and also in terms of promotions, which is of course tied up to the rewards. We said that most of the time women are usually overlooked because there's no sometimes data or information that shows that they're capable of doing the job. So you find that most managerial jobs at the top, especially the newsrooms, and this across, you find that they don't get there because the data simply is not sufficient to enable them to articulate why they need to be promoted. And also you find that unfortunately this is true, most of the newsroom, we have men at the leadership, so the women kind of tend to be overlooked at. And you find that women who are doing the same job as the men sometimes are paid less than their male counterpart, and this is because sometimes there is no data. So that data helps in ensuring that there's equal pay for the right for the equal job done, irrespective of the gender. So big data also helps the company have a very holistic approach into the organization. It's able to integrate new capabilities in terms of what are the skill sets or what are the capabilities we need for the company in future in terms of building our journalist. What kind of skills do you need to build with? Is it fact finding, data visualization, infographics, so they can be able to drive the business? Also taking a very work-centric shift. This is in regard to looking at work more in depth, and also addressing culture shift that is internally the kind of workforce which are coming on board as the other generation, older generation retires, and also the demands of our readers out there in being able to get information fast and also online from their phones without having to wait for the paper the next day. And another a very, very important aspect of embracing big data is automation of processes. We find that our journalists, by nature of their job, they're usually out there in the field gathering data. So have we been able to enable them by giving them tools where they can be able to get the data and be able to take the photos and write the stories? Also, are they able to do their balance scorecard out there without having to come off in the office? So they can be able to do their work out there and also be able to deliver. So it's very important to have the operation of process is very important, because also you can be able to monitor the performance of the employees. You can be able to track in terms of where the issues of stories which are not having a lot of fact finding and causing the company a lot of litigation. You're able to get this information when you have the data or provides systems which can be able to track this, and you can be able to address it on time. As we do all this big data, what are usually the findings from the HR? And we find that from the HR, we will look at areas of being able to build our skills and knowledge of the journalists, because you're looking at the companies for the future. What are the capabilities we need for companies for the future? And one of this is we need, our journalists need to learn how to deal with digital media and the rich demands of the world news. Digital media is a big thing, because you're able to get the information instantaneously, and it's from wherever you are. You don't have to be confined to a specific area. So it's very important that we give the skills that can be able to do digital media. Another area is also content production that caters for multimedia. More than ever before, we have to equip our employees with information which they can not only do as a print journalist, but also as a TV journalist, and also as a write for digital, and also write for radio, so that you can be able to know what content goes where, and you have the skill to know what needs to go fast and what needs to wait. Also understanding the deadlines across the platform that I've just spoken to. Also, journalists are required to have skills for the web, video, social, print, TV, and media, and radio. That's when you talk about having a multifaceted and multimedia journalist as opposed to a one-line journalist. Also, they need to have the skills to be able to do immediate analysis. So it's very important on issue of fact-finding, and also data verification and visualization. Get the data, break it down in a format that is digestible to the audience. In this case, the infographics become in very handy here. Historical backup and research. You find that more than ever before, as you do the documentaries and the features, you need to ensure that you have very consequent and very systematic information that will show the journey from the story or the documentary they are doing, and keep our audience very engaged. Social media engagement and managing online reactions. We find that we have a lot of chat box these days, and also online engagers who are able to manage to handle our audiences out there. And we find that the chat box might well to be able to do the frequently asked questions, but with the online engagers or journalists with that skill, they're able to deal with more complex matters or issues that come up when dealing with the customers. Context development. This is more in terms of being in the settings of the communication, being able to have information that can work in a way that you're able to influence the information, the data, and create a curiosity for the audience or the readers to be able to get that information from wherever it is, if it's TV, if it's digital, or if it's on print. Also, additional depth. The information has to be really in-depth in a manner that you just don't give people what they know. Give them what they do not know. So you need to get a little bit in-depth in any story that you carry as a journalist. Infographics. We are told pictures say 1,000 words. Please be able to, it's very important that we have a graphic representation of data in terms of graphs, in terms of maps, in terms of being able to put it in a table form and communicate easily and just by a glance. Also, data analytics, very, very crucial, because it means we have to source for data, be able to process it, and be able to make very informed decisions with this data. So thank you very much. I'm going to close with a word from Charles Darwin, or a very renowned scientist, who said it's not only the strongest or the most intelligent who survive, but those who are best to manage the change. This change is coming as we move towards big data, embracing artificial intelligence, and being able to change for the future, so that you can be able to meet the needs of every of our audience, listener and reader. Thank you very much, and I've got to go. Bye bye. Thank you.